Hello and welcome to Point of View. China today added another chapter in its ambitious space station mission. Today it successfully launched a Tianzhou-3 cargo spacecraft from the new coastal Wenchang Center on the southern island of Hainan. Tianzhou-3 was launched atop a Long March 7 carrier rocket, carrying the second resupply mission for the Tiangong-3 space station. It was the third launch of Tianzhou spacecraft and the sixth mission of a Long March 7 rocket. This was China's 34th orbital launch of the year. Overall, this is the fourth China space station mission and will deliver supplies for Shenzhou-13 crew that is due to launch in October. There are a total of 11 launches needed for the construction phase of the China's space station Tiangong. The Tianzhou-3 mission will supply the Tianhe core module with enough propellant to maintain its orbital altitude. The spacecraft is expected to dock with the space station within 24 hours of launch. The Tianzhou, which means heavenly boat, is an automated cargo spacecraft that will function as the main resupply vehicle for the Tiangong space station. The first Tianzhou spacecraft, Tianzhou-1, launched on a Long March 7 rocket from Wenchang in April 2017. This spacecraft is 10.6 meters long and has a diameter of 3.35 meters. It consists of two main parts: a cargo cabin and a propulsion section. The Tiangong space station, which means heavenly palace, is a space station currently under construction in low Earth orbit. When complete, the station will be roughly one-fifth the mass of the International Space Station. The Tiangong space station will operate in orbit for at least 10 years. Its construction began on April 29, 2021, when the core module, the Tianhe, meaning Harmony of the Heavens, was launched on a Long March 5B rocket. The Tianhe core module is able to accommodate three crew members with a built-in life support system. It is 16.6 meters long and has a diameter of 4.2 meters. This module can also provide propulsion to maintain the orbital altitude of the station. Later, it will be joined by the two other modules, Mengtian and Wentian, that will host Chinese and international science experiments. China aims to construct the three-module space station with 11 launches across 2021 and 2022. Once completed, it will conclude three-module launches, four cargo spacecraft, and four crewed missions. While the station will comprise three modules, it will have the capability to expand to six, and it's expected to be operational for at least 10 years. The first crewed flight of the station took place on June 17, 2021. The three astronauts from the mission have already returned home on September 17, 2021. The Long March 7 is a three-stage medium-lift launch vehicle capable of lifting a 13,500-kilogram payload into low Earth orbit or a 7,000-kilogram payload into geostationary transfer orbit. The standard version of the Long March 7 can be upgraded by adding more boosters, allowing it to be capable of reaching higher orbits or executing multiple orbital deployments. The center core of the Long March 7 can be supported by either two or four boosters, which use refined kerosene and liquid oxygen propellant. The boosters are powered by an oxidized rich stage combustion YF-100 engine. At sea level, each booster provides 1,200 kN of thrust. The center core of the rocket is 3.35 meters in diameter and has two YF-100 engines. Like the boosters, this first stage uses refined kerosene and liquid oxygen. At sea level, this stage produces 2,400 kilonewton of thrust, increasing to 2,860 kilonewton in a vacuum. Like the first stage, the second stage is also 3.35 meters in diameter and uses refined kerosene and liquid oxygen. This stage is powered by 4 oxidizer-rich stage combustion YF-115 engines, 2 of which are fixed and 2 of which can gimbal. The 2-stage offers 706 kN of thrust in a vacuum. Here's wishing the mission success and smooth docking with Tianhe. That's a wrap. Thanks for watching.